guys, welcome back to NautiStyles. First of all, do you have your notification bell on? Right here underneath the video, just make sure you have that click. This way you never ever miss a new video. Also, you guys keep asking me, where do Rico and I get our cool nautical watches? We are actually proud ambassadors for Crown and Caliber. Check them out. Quick shout out to our awesome sponsor. Today we're in Florida and we are on board of SUNREEF 60 Sail. You guys might have seen a video we did a while back at the Cannes Yacht Festival of Project E, which is an eco catamaran. In that video, we focused on all the eco features. In this video, we're gonna show you a real detailed NautiStyles tour of a SUNREEF 60 Sail. So welcome to AMAYA. This bow. This is insane.
And keep in mind, this is a 60-foot catamaran. This is the bow space of a 100-foot monohull. You can have a dance party here.
It's absolutely incredible. Just keep in mind, it just rained. We just got lucky. The rain just stopped, so there's some wet spots on the cushions. Yeah, so I have this absolutely spacious bow with layout cushions, also really cool sitting area right here. We have this weather door, which is really, really cool. It opens up like that, and yeah, we can show it to you guys in a little bit. All right, we're gonna open up some hatches, but I'm gonna get my assistant to do it.
All righty.
He said he prefers to be called co-star.
Co-host star.
Did you say coaster?
No, like a co-star.
Oh, I thought you said coaster.
All right.
All right, what do we got?
Storage, plenty of storage.
Okay.
All right. Let's keep going.
There's a lot to see, so.
All right, I'm just gonna, since I'm already here.
Go for it. Holy moly! Wow.
That is a very deep storage.
Nice.
Yeah. Okay.
Cool.
Open the next one. Oh, just see here, receptacles, I assume for like a sunshade?
Correct, yeah, there's receptacles right there, yeah, and there's a sunshade that comes in here.
Oh, got it. Okay, so here we have access to our anchor chain, our windlass, our bridle, all the chain right there.
Oh my God, look at that chain.
Woo! That's a lot of chain. Yeah. And that's a big chain. I mean, there's so much storage here. Look at this. And another hatch.
There's more. Wow.
Fender storage. Woo! Also very large.
That is a lot. I mean, there's like 10 of me could fit in there.
Hangers for lines, for dock lines.
Where?
Like right
that.
There.
Hold on.
Fantastic.
Oh yeah, very cool.
Very
Show that
cool.
again. Hangers?
Yep. Hangers right here.
Very nice.
For lines, for dock lines.
Check out the Flybridge.
The rig. What do we got next?
I want to see the bow locker.
Bow lockers.
Yeah.
Let's just go over to the starboard side.
Oh, it's really hard to follow this guy.
There is another one. Mirror image to the port side. More fender storage.
Right.
All right. Woo! Getting warm.
Yeah, it's not easy to be a star. Okay.
Oh, wow, look at this forepeak. Well, that's a really deep storage. I mean, with the shelves and everything, it's amazing.
Yeah, that staircase is crazy. It's so long.
Yeah.
All right, should we go aft?
Let's go aft.
Oh, I see a feature I like.
Ooh.
Lights.
Beautiful. Really like how they incorporated all these little courtesy lights in the bulwarks. Got your aft cleats here. Stairs down to jump in the water, which I could totally do right now.
Oh, it's really hot, you guys. So the sugar scoops are not that big because you have this massive SUNREEF signature hydraulic swim platform, and it is really, really big, and you can choose to have movable furniture that can go on there when it's down. It's like a real beach club. It's super cool.
And it has a really high capacity. I mean, we're looking at a pretty heavyweight tender, so no problem at all with that.
Check out this cockpit. So it being semi-custom, there is so much you can do. You can have this table completely loose. It could be here with special strap-in points, and it could be this way as well. It could easily sit 10 people. You can have movable furniture. This one's cool because you can switch it this way when the swim step is, you know, without the tender.
The backrest can go the other way.
Yeah. So you can sit and watch a beautiful sunset the other way.
If you don't want to have a bench at all, you don't need to have that either. And you can just have it completely open.
Correct. Really, really cool. So this is really massive. So here we have wet bar entertainment space. Have a wet bar sink.
For the cockpit area.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Ice maker. Fridge.
Perfect.
Nice size fridge. These are really big storage compartments. I think they're equal, right? Show you one of them.
Oh, wow. Yeah, they're really good size and deep.
Great for provisioning, perfect. Extra stuff.
Very inviting covered cockpit area here. There's our crew entrance.
Correct. The crew entrance is here. And then as you guys can tell, what's really awesome, it's just the way it flows into the salon because all these doors open completely, fully open. So it's just this massive space here. And this is one of Rico's favorite things.
Love these.
Yeah.
They just look so nice. The teak wooden drains.
That's definitely on our must-have list.
The deck drains, I love them.
Flybridge.
Yes.
Follow me.
Hey.
Wow. This is really cute. Such a cute little design here. So, as we said, it being semi-custom, you can kind of do whatever you want here. You don't need to have a built-in furniture. You can just have, as you guys can see on the other SUNREEF we toured, completely kind of an open, movable furniture. So if you get sick of it, you can just get a new furniture, super easy and really nice. They opt for this table here, which is massive. Put extra chairs.
Oh, it's foldable.
Yeah, huge sitting area with a big table.
Yeah, I mean, that probably gives you easily a 10 person dinner opportunity up here on the Flybridge. And then also, I know that there's an option because I've spec'd one out before. There's an option for jacuzzi right here. If you want one.
A hot tub.
Hot tub jacuzzi, yeah.
Let's check out the helm. This really feels
nice
like
helm bench.
It feels like a power yacht seat, right?
Does the front part flip up if you want to use it as a booster seat?
I think so. Yes.
Nice. Awesome.
Very cool.
So this boat is outfitted with a starboard helm. Got our helm, our wheel here, all our electronics, BNG in this case, but there could be any other brand, whatever you like. Your engine, throttle, and shift controls, your VHF radio, the necessary navigation switches, and your engine controls. All the winches are just forward off the helm, all electric winches.
What about the visibility, huh?
And now the visibility just got a lot better.
No, thank you.
And then even docking, I mean, this is not a big problem because the visibility is actually really, really good, as you guys can see.
Can't imagine being underweight right here. So cool.
And right now, I got to tell you, it's pretty warm here, right? And this is the nicest spot right now up here. We have a little bit of a breeze here on the Flybridge.
So nice.
So having this big entertainment space is fantastic. So we got electric winches all over from the port to the starboard side, all your lines going just straight down the mast.
Look how big this is.
Look at the size of the mast.
Wow.
Amazing. I like the boom, the V-boom. Sail is sitting in there really nicely. And it's a really big rig. So this boat is outfitted with a hard top, which is an option, which I really like.
great visibility you can to also, all your sails.
It's also nice to have the hard top because you can choose to put solar panels on top.
Solar panels, lights, speakers, mm-hmm. whatever you want to put in.
What about the lines here?
You get all your lines, all your important lines, all your running rigging is right down the on the mast. You have a big line storage down here. You want to clean it up. Two big layout cushions here, port and starboard side.
And there's this nice entertainment area here.
So much space on this Flybridge.
Yeah, so you have a wet bar, sink right here.
Uh-huh.
Barbecue, trash.
Awesome.
And also your
propane locker.
Propane locker there. Fridge, drink fridge, and the ice maker.
Watertight door, weather door again, to protect the cockpit from the Flybridge if you have some bad weather. Got a life raft, actually two life rafts mounted aft of the Flybridge. Communications are right here.
So let's check out inside. Coming in. Nice and air-conditioned.
Beautiful.
Wow, what a difference. All right, so we are in the salon. Check it out. So this is a 60-foot catamaran. And as you guys can tell, it is an enormous amount of space on this yacht.
And then also the doors we just came in, they can be slide open all the way.
Completely. Just gonna keep it closed because we have a really nice air conditioning going, but you guys have just, you know, you can imagine that. We have a salon area, which is a really nice, spacious couch here with seats. Again, it's a semi-custom shipyard, so you can kind of create a lot of different options here. I can have a sitting layout area here that we've seen as well. You can kind of configure this into a more of a couch, like connected. So there's different ways of doing it, but this is the way this boat is set up. It's very nice. The wood, right? The flooring is
beautiful.
Amazing. Just the way it feels, it's pretty fantastic. Just find out what that is.
I really like the indirect lighting underneath the bar area, all around on the ceiling. It looks like this table actually extends out to become a proper dinner table.
Ta-da!
For everybody who's asking, where's the TV?
There's a good size TV in here.
There it is.
Perfectly hidden.
Nice automated TV lift.
Very cool.
Fantastic.
So,
should we explore?
Yes. Well, I am dying to check out this galley. So this island is massive. It is really big. I don't know if this is translatable, but just check it out how big it is. Everything is built in and nicely hidden, so it all looks super clean and just gorgeous. Huge freezer, nice size refrigerator.
Even bigger refrigerator.
Yeah.
I mean, this is... That's a really good size refrigerator.
Yeah, it's great. I love when it's just completely
What do you think
hidden.
Of the mirrored finish?
Well, the way it doesn't feel like those, you know, bright mirrors. It's that kind of a tinted mirror finish. It's really nice. It looks very classy and it makes the space bigger. Again, it's totally a preference. So if you guys don't like that, you can make it into this nice wooden finish. You can make it into a full-blown, just, you know, kind of a regular fridge, if that's your thing. All right, so come on in the galley. So we have a double sink, kind of a smaller sink here. Oh, wow, there's all that storage there. Look, that
can
looks
you,
like
can
some
you,
kind
can
of
you, can
storage.
Can you reach any of that?
This looks like it comes out. Wow. It's great for appliances that you don't use often, or maybe certain, like, bigger pots and stuff that you don't use all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Super cool, just stored away. And look at all these here.
What is that?
There's a knife.
Oh, nice,
space.
Look at that.
I mean, however you choose to use it.
Those are, very those are practical.
Pretty deep spaces here.
And then you want there's me to more. Reach this?
Yeah. Look at that.
Pots and pans.
Uh-huh.
And there's...
There's way more.
Two more of these.
Yeah, this is for stuff that is not used often. But I gotta say, I think I would love to have them, you know, just kind of come up, maybe, come out. Maybe electric, that would be really cool.
Which they're I'm just, pretty sure you can do.
Yeah, they just lift up and you know, it's easy to reach, so that would be really nice. All right, what else we got here?
All right.
Trash.
Just good size drawers.
Really nice. Yeah, look how nice and deep it is. Oh, here you guys, there's a perspective of how big this island is.
Fantastic.
It's pretty massive.
Yeah.
So you could have, if that's your thing, set this island up as a little breakfast nook, easily for like 4 or 5 chairs here. If that's what you wanted to do, you could do that.
Absolutely.
All right, so moving on, gas stove, 5 burner.
And what do we got here below?
Mealy oven.
Is that an oven? Yeah, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, that looks like an oven.
Rika's favorite German brand.
And then we have another oven right next to it, slightly larger.
Larger, yeah.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Redundancy.
Interesting. Okay.
I really like the hood.
Oh yeah,
looks
look at
so
that.
So stylish.
Super cool, and it has nice lighting built in there too.
All right, what do we get on the other side?
Wow, it just keeps going. Okay.
All right, starting in the back.
Also, there is a wine cooler right here as well, a really nice one.
Very nice.
Favorite brand.
We got our interior nav station here with all the necessary controls you need. You have your yacht management system here. We have our Vectron energy controls here. Our fire boys are here. This opens up. There we go. Got our 2 water maker controls here, good for the redundancy. Our bilge systems here. 2 generators are right here, and our electronics, BNG chart plotter, and then BNG autopilot controls and remote, and of course, VHF.
These blinds are not electric. Again, the owner of this boat has chosen those things, so they can't be all electric, so these are manual, just to give you guys visibility. Pretty sweet.
I mean, the size of the windows on the Sunreef Yachts are amazing. Visibility
cool.
All around is really, really fantastic.
Okay, cool. So should we check out the cabins?
Yes.
All right. This way?
Whichever way you want to start.
All right, we'll start on the starboard side.
Starboard forward.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this is a 5 cabin layout plus crew.
Correct.
Okay.
So this is a lot of cabins, you guys. Obviously, you can only imagine what it would look like if you had 4 cabin layout or so. Get ready.
Yep.
So there's a really nice indirect lighting here, which is super cool.
Makes it very safe.
So we're gonna come forward. They chose to have these mirrors everywhere. You don't have to do that. It is definitely a personal choice. And to be honest, I do like it. It just makes the cabin bigger and it's really nice and tinted. So the finishes are really nice. There's like almost like a velour gray finishes there. They went with kind of a lighter cabinetry here. So let's see, storage wise, there's storage areas here. Check that out.
Mm-hmm.
That's a great size.
Okay, they're getting wider in the back, so you have a little bit extra storage down there.
Also, storage right there.
Yep, the further you go back, the bigger the storage is getting. What is this?
This is a kinetic closet. It's pretty great for like a week out, you know, that's plenty of space for a little cruise.
Yeah, that's great.
I mean, this is set up for, you know, being able to take a good amount of people on board or charter. So not really set up as, you know, a liveaboard, I think, because then you'll prefer having a little bit less cabins. So yeah, just keep that in mind. All right. Do you think there's a storage here?
I think there are drawers on the very bottom.
On the very bottom. Yes, they are.
Yep.
Well, they're
a big deep storage.
Just kind of a deep storage. There we go.
Yep.
Oh, those are great.
You put your shoes in there or something.
Yeah, very nice.
I just noticed this here. Right next to your bed, you have these phone charging stations. You just put your phone on it, no cable needed, no nothing. And it's also nicely indirectly lit up and it looks really nice.
And the headroom, you guys, is really good. Check it out.
Oh yeah.
Really nice headroom. You can definitely sit in the bed. It's great.
And we got a overhead hatch here, which is just closed right now.
Yeah,
But we can open that up. There we go.
And also, let's show you guys the windows, right? Again, you can choose to have this electric if you have the money to spend. Look at these windows.
Waking up in bed and looking right over the ocean.
Those are great windows. That's kind of a signature Sunreef windows, and they're awesome.
Really nice.
Yep, you can open this for some cross breeze, so it's nice. Obviously, all the cabins are air conditioned.
Got a TV.
Mm-hmm. Where? Oh, here. All right, and then we keep going forward. That's the head,
dedicated
ensuite.
So we have a fan running in here. If I turn the lights off, this one.
Can we turn the fan off?
But then the lights turn off too.
I got you. Okay.
So yes, we can, but...
This is a really nice lighting, actually.
It's very nice. Mm-hmm. I also like the details on the door. So you have your... I mean, look at the size of these doors. It's a proper door.
That's very SUNREEF. Like, everything is quality and thick, and it just feels... Yeah, just nice
All the hardware.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we have a sink. Again, that's a lot of cabins, so just keep that in mind. Great size shower for the size of the cabin. Check it out. Nice headroom. I can't even reach it, and I'm 5'7", so great headroom. Here you've got a rain shower, regular shower, whatever that's European shower head called. Ta-da!
Good storage. Mm-hmm. And again, we have an overhead hatch, which has right now the sunscreen in, but you can open it up and create some nice cross breeze too if you don't want to use the air condition. Wow. Good size.
Yeah, that's more than I expected, actually.
Very functional.
Great little cabin. Yeah, very nice. All right, let's keep going. We have a lot more cabins to see. All right, let's keep going. So we have a pretty much matching cabin right here. They're doing some work. They ask us to not film it, but it's pretty much the same thing, just to give you an idea. So another one of the one we just saw.
So also with an ensuite. And
correct.
You want to close the door and see what is behind here?
Good idea.
So what do we got here? Linen?
Yeah.
Linen closet.
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Everything feels very solid.
Definitely.
Right?
Yeah, let's keep going.
Kind of like what you would expect in a higher-end residential home.
Yeah, well, the cool thing is that you could pick your own finishes, and, you know, there's a lot of options. So also, they're open to maybe specific things that they don't offer, but maybe you really, really want the specific floor. They're open to if you're sourcing stuff. So that's very interesting. So that's a possibility for someone who's very particular.
All right, I'm going aft.
Yes, so we're going
starboard.
Aft.
Starboard.
Mm-hmm.
Everywhere you have these charging stations, which obviously the owner picked for this specific boat because he wanted to include it. But I think it's a very...
Huge storage here.
Huge storage.
And
very good idea.
And there are electrical outlets there.
Mm-hmm. Awesome.
All right, let's go. So as we come down, we have a whole bunch of storage areas right here. Washer and I'm assuming dryer. Okay, and then we're coming into this cabin here. Wow, look at these doors.
I know.
All right, come on in. Kind of the same.
Kind of like a mirror image.
Mm-hmm, a little bit. Yeah, you have the same storage stuff here. Oh, wait, there's a closet here.
Mm-hmm.
Very similar. So you also have the same kind of layout here with storage areas. Same beautiful window here. So we have a pocket door into the ensuite. Yeah, this layout is actually really nice. Tons of counter space. Nice medicine cabinet.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. A little more.
Good amount of storage.
That's actually really nice for this size of a head, for sure. Let's check out the shower. Oh, this one is even bigger. This is nice. The fan is running here, babe.
Really nice lighting in there.
Mm-hmm. Nice and direct lighting and super nice.
Look at the height. Can you reach the ceiling?
Not really.
Barely. Barely reach the ceiling.
Barely.
Really nice.
I am really looking forward to seeing a master.
Let's go over to the port side.
Okay. So we're coming to the port side. One of the really cool features of the SUNREEF is this awesome weather-tight door. It is so nice to be able to feel super safe here, but also have this awesome access. You can open it up if you're in a galley, just the easy access to the bow.
Well, another thing is also like when the summer and the hot temperatures are over, you don't necessarily need to run air conditioned 24/7. You can create a great cross breeze here.
Absolutely. You open all of these doors. I mean, that's just a complete open cockpit. And then you open this up,
super cool.
Especially sitting on anchor when you get, you know, wind always from all over the bow.
Totally.
This is making such a big difference.
Yeah, you can have dinner down there because usually it's, you know, if you don't have that option, having dinner sometimes in the cockpit is really hot.
Yeah.
So because you're, a lot of the times the wind is obviously coming when you're anchored from the front. So yeah, from the bow. So you don't get that there. So that makes it super nice.
Cool.
The master?
Port side. Let's go.
Oh, there's more than a master there, right? The one you had one, two, three, two more cabins.
Should be two cabins there, right?
All right. Come on down. We're going to go forward. Pretty much the same thing, same cabins as we saw over there. So all nice and equal, great for charter because no one's really arguing about any cabins. It's all super.
So it's like a mirror image to the starboard cabin, you're saying?
Yeah.
Really beautiful.
Same thing. So we're not going to open everything up. You guys already seen it a couple times.
If you look at the materials, it looks like a 5-star hotel.
Yeah, it's very nice. Definitely. There's a little bidet here. Great shower. Man, the headroom is great. Really great. Yeah. A lot of the catamarans you're on, it does really feel kind of closed in. This is a lot of headroom here for sure.
Really nice.
Great shower.
I got two of you.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. All right.
The master. Okay. Closet again?
Yep. Like we had on the other one, like all the unaccounted storage, right?
Yeah, same exact thing. There's something right here before we head into the master. Oh, wow, this is a big one. Check that out.
Very large linen closet.
Yeah, that's huge.
look how high up it is. You need a ladder to get up there.
Yeah, that's crazy. I cannot reach the ceiling, you guys, at all. Like, only if I jump.
Yeah.
Ready? Okay. Coming into the master.
Oh, you're noticeably more space.
Definitely. I mean, again, it's a 5-cabin plus crew, so it is definitely a smaller master. You could choose to have a much larger master on this size of a sunreef.
And then also, good-sized TV, a little office nook or makeup area, with a little ottoman there.
Yep, storage here as well. And also, you've got this overhead storage here, too.
Oh, wow.
Which is really, really deep.
Here, too.
Closet.
Wow.
But look, there is a little step up, and I'm actually standing on it, and my head still cannot reach the ceiling. It is very tall. So the freeboard on this boat is really tall, right?
Especially for a 60-footer.
So this is very cute. Check it out.
There's lots of storage.
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah, we got this little couch here. Getting ready, get dressed couch.
So I haven't seen the full closet, so it is probably still coming up. So it kept coming aft. Oh, I really like how they did this. So the shower is this way.
So the shower is inboard.
Uh-huh, very cool.
Really like it.
Oh, it's big. What is that?
Very nice.
Oh,
lighting.
Nice.
Very nice.
Oh, it changes. You've got like a little
disco
in the shower.
What do we got on the outboard side here?
So this is our closet. Oh, nice. Very nice.
Oh, that's big.
This would be my closet.
That would be your closet.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. But look, there's also drawers. Big drawer here. Oh, that's really big. And everything feels like nice, heavy duty, so good quality.
Soft closing.
Yeah. Big drawers.
Wow, that's massive.
Mm-hmm. There's a hatch here. There's also a hatch over there, so that would be nice to open. And then...
Well, what's missing?
The head is still in here. Come on in. Oh, check this out. It's kind of nice here. Got a little...
Yeah, a little porthole.
Porthole, yeah. There's storage spaces here.
Really nice.
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I like it.
Okay, so look, there's your toilet paper.
Oh, that's nice.
That's cute. Engine Ready. Room and...
Crew quarters.
Let's go. Crew quarters on the port side, just as soon as you come down.
Access right through the cockpit.
Correct. for two crew bunks with a head here.
Oh, that's actually really comfortable bunks.
And the shower, I guess, you know, that would be your combo shower.
A little bit on the smaller side, but definitely functional.
Yeah, a little bit on the smaller side. It doesn't have a separate shower, but I'm sure there's a way to reconfigure if you really wanted to.
Good amount of space to walk around.
Yep.
And again, even here, a full-size mirror.
I mean, that's a lot of cabins for this 60-foot boat, for sure. So there's tons of storage here. There's a safe. Look at that.
Oh, wow, this is deep storage.
Yeah, so actually crew has a good amount of storage. Of the nice hanging locker here. Great size.
Really good.
Yeah, very good. And there's some drawers, I think, underneath the bed as well.
Yep.
Yeah, very nice.
And then we got some more storage right where we entered. Shoe storage.
Yeah, a little shoe storage here.
Oh, I like that.
Yeah, that's a cute one.
Very functional. Even here we have a TV. We got a hatch overhead. And we have a porthole, which opens as well.
Cool.
USB outlets everywhere. That's great.
Engine room. The engine room.
The engine room.
Guess who's
and
going?
Also, what I just saw, this boat is outfitted with a Passerelle, which is an option. If you're cruising Europe, you probably want to have that.
All righty, the engine room. So we got a Yanmar 110 on each side. We got our Cummins generator right there. And a water maker right there. Accessibility is pretty decent. Got our electrical panels and switchovers all in here as well.
This completes our tour of the SUNREEF 60-cell AMAYA. I know you guys enjoyed this one, so if you are interested in purchasing a SUNREEF, all the contact information will be in the description below. As always, please like, share, and comment. It really, really helps our channel. I'll see you guys in the next one. Enjoy the outtakes.
I like your outfit.
Thank you.
Thanks. Oh.
Cool.
Hold on, one more time. Good.
Just do some pants or something.
Pants? I'm wearing a skirt. But check. You guys might have hint. You done for today?
Back to you. I'm sweating.
I'm not sweating. Alright, so we're gonna go
vet
bar.
A little wet bar.
Yeah. Marco.
Polo.
Marco.
It's great visibility, even for the skipper.
Yes, skipper, let's go.
Yeah, let's go. No, there's a breeze. It's going to stop pouring in a second.
It's a semi-custom shipyard.
I just said that all of that.
Okay.
Aha. Uh-huh. Huge freezer.
Huge freezer. Repeating what you're saying. What is really important for you every time we go out, a full-size mirror. So having this double functioning as a full-size mirror, here's the door, there's the mirror. Off you go.
A husband that pays attention. Thank you, baby.
You're welcome.
Oh, a huge feature. Okay, ready? Ready?
Gotta put a pull sign on there.
Ready?
Ready.
I'm afraid to press it, because I don't want a rain shower to come down on me and my head.
Just push it.
No.
Come on.
You do it. Are you scared? Nothing
happens.
What is that?
It's for something. We don't know what it is for.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is.
Flush out to C button.
You think? Oh, now it's on. Oh!
Oh, lighting.
Nice. There you go.
Woo.
Hot?
Hot.
Welcome to Florida. We're totally LA babies. It's too warm for us. Rico and I are proud ambassadors for Crown & Caliber, which is a luxury watch online store. Check them out. I'll see you guys in the next one. What do you keep looking at? Oh, is that an 80?
That's an 80 right there.
Should we go tour that one?
Yeah, let's check that out.
All right, let's go. I'll see you in the 80.
Enjoy the outtakes.
Bye.